Hello and welcome to this video tutorial for QF Test. QF Test, the tool for GUI test automation for Java and web applications. This video is the video version also of the tutorial which comes with our QF Test distribution, which is available via the help menu and which is also available in a written form on our webpage below support documentation. There is the tutorial, and this tutorial is based on three parts. There is one for Java GUI testing, one deals with web GUI testing, and part three explains advanced features of QF test. In this part here, we will start with the first one, with Java GUI testing. And within this tutorial, we will cover the following points. We will start working with a sample test suite. We will create then our test suite from scratch. We will write procedures. We will see how components and component recognition works within QF test. We will use the debugger. We will also have a look at variables, especially as procedure parameters. There is the standard library, which provides a lot of procedures out of the box. Then we have control structures like if, then, else, try, catch. And then, at least then, it's time to start your own application and to give it a try. Okay, we will start with part one, working with a sample test suite. So this is the QF test main window. And here within the left part, we will see a tree structure where everything takes place, where we will receive our recordings, where we can build up our test cases. And on the right side, there are the details for the node selected on the left side. And these are the attributes defining this node. And all these attributes can be edited and changed and adapted as necessary. In the top part, there are the most usual actions in this toolbar, like capture replay. And in the bottom right area, there is a terminal window which shows, for instance, the standard output of QF test and also of the system to be tested. So then I've already loaded the sample test suite. It's located within the QF test distribution. Typically, it's installed below C, program files, QFS, QF test. Then there is the version specific directory, and below there is a doc directory and the tutorial directory. And inside there are a number of sample test suites, and we will use the first Java test suite. Okay, let's have a look what's inside. This test suite contains two test cases, a first one and a second one with an error by intention. And there is a setup node to start the demo, so QF test can get control on this demo. And there is a cleanup sequence to stop the demo. So what's necessary for starting the demo? Let's have a brief look in here. There is first a central node to set a global variable, and it's the central so-called client variable. And this client variable defines with which application we want to interact, because if we can have more than one application started at the same time. And by this variable, we define which is the one to talk to. But in our examples, we just have one, and we have given this variable the name carconfig. We will see why this is, because the application is called carconfigurator. Okay. And the next step is a sequence which says start client if necessary and dependent on operating system. That means the client is just started if it's necessary, if it's not already running. And there is an if clause which says for Windows, we use a command file here to start the application. And for instance, on Linux, it's a shell script. Okay, so let's execute this sequence. So we'll see here some output is generated in the terminal window. And after a few seconds, our demo application appears. And it's, as already said, a small demo where you can configure vehicles and where you can calculate a price for your vehicle. The first test case consists of four steps. There is one step to reset the demo application to have a defined state for beginning with the test. And what's in here are three mouse clicks. And we can read that it's a click to a menu file, reset, and a tapped pane. So this is file, reset, and there is a click on the tapped pane with the index 0, so that the first tab is selected. So this is the reset sequence. The second test step is a selection of the model i5, which means something like that. The third step is the selection of a special model called Jazz. And this is a click here and a selection from the combo. And it's the Jazz selection. And the final step is a verification step. It's a check node where the text is verified of this calculated price field. It's the field here, this final price field. And you see, as I have done the same steps by hand as it's typically done within the automated test, the value is the same one here. So this dollar value is the same as here, and it's checked. So, okay, let's see this to run. So I execute this, and you can see the execution is also highlighted in the QF test tree when it's going down here. And you see that also that the execution went through the application to be tested. And there was no error. We can see this in this right bottom corner here. The status is finished. There was no error. And it was one test case that was executed, and the one was also successful. So we have a success rate of 100%. Okay, let's have a look at the second test case with error. So they are basically the same steps despite of the third one. And the third one is one where a 10% discount is granted by inserting the value 10 in this field. And this leads to a reduction here at the final price value. Okay, let's see this getting executed. And quite by intention, an error occurs. And we see there was no exception, one error, no warning. And now there is also a button here, show run log, because that is a typical necessary action when an error occurs, that you want to see what is the reason for this error. And to help you and to support you with this, QF test logs special information where you can see what might have gone wrong. And we can open this run log by pressing this button, or if the dialog has already been closed, you can also use this button in the toolbar to open the last run log. By the way, here you can also see that result of one error here in the status line. So the run log opens up and it looks similar to the nodes as they are shown in the test suite. But now these nodes have a timely order. So it's the execution order of these steps. So every node owns a timestamp and an execution time. So you can see the whole execution took about 1 second here. And We also see there are nodes having a red border around, and that means below such a node there is an error or an exception located. Here these are errors. And we could drill down here, but we can also use a more convenient way to directly jump to the error by this button, find next error. So I press it and I directly jump into the correspondent node where I get the error message, which says mismatch expected was the value 29,000 and I got a value of 26,000, simply because the 10% discount was not taken into consideration, but this was done by intention to help us showing this run log. Beside this error message, there are screenshots that QF just automatically takes from, for instance, from the application at the time when the error occurs, but there are also screenshots from the whole screen, and that can get very handy to see in what status the application is when the error occurred. So now what to do with the error? In our case, the error has been inserted by intention and simply the expected price needs to be adapted. And for this, we can use here the feature when having selected the node where the actual error message is shown, there is an option within the context menu of this node to update the check node with current data. That means if you simply need to update the data in your test case, you can use this option here. And when pressing this, the value is adapted within the text check. And now when executing this second test case, it works well without error. So one final word on these run logs. You see here the additional information compact. That means this kind of run log here automatically removes nodes from the run log that are not needed, because run logs may grow very fast when your test becomes more complex and you get longer running tests. And for this, there is the feature that QF test just keeps that information that is typically necessary for the error analysis. That means just information before an error situation is kept, a number, a special number of events before the error situation, and other information that is not necessary is removed from the run log. Okay, now we come to a kind of intermediate section to help you or to show you where to get help when you are looking, for instance, for a feature. And for this, the help menu is a good point of entry. And there is one helpful action here, online search, which gets you to the QF test website. And here you have an online search, which searches all kind of documentation, the tutorial, the manual, the mailing list, and standard library documentation. And for instance, let's search for compact run log. And then if we want to see, is there something in the tutorial, then I can use this filter mechanism here. And this narrows the search down to two hits. And you can see when jumping here, we are in here. And if we would search here for compact, we will exactly find this location where compact run logs are explained. So this is very helpful. And another very helpful helping feature is the context sensitive help QF test offers. For instance, for any node, there is an entry in the context menu. It's called what's this? And this directly gets you to the respective reference documentation in the manual. And not just for nodes, but even for attributes, this is possible. So if I click right here, this is the command attribute from this setup node. And when jumping to this, it directly gets you to this comment, to the explanation of this comment attribute, and this is the one from the setup node. So this is also very helpful. So then, after having seen the test cases, we are back at the cleanup node. So this is a node for cleaning up the test run, and this can be done as one option to stop the demo. And having a look in here, this consists simply of a stop client node where the client, our car config client, is just stopped in a hard way. Another option, for instance, would be to use the file exit action, but here to have it simple, we just use a hard stop client node available directly from QFTest and await for the termination. So if I execute this, zack, the client vanishes. So now we have covered all the nodes in this test set, and so it's time to give the full test set an execution. So I do this, and let's see how it behaves. So the application comes up and both test cases are executed, and the expected error here is also shown. And let's have a look into the run log. And here we see the execution, and we see the first test case and the second test case with the error. And we see that the setup and the cleanup is executed before and after each of the test cases to ensure a clean state and a cleanup after each. Of course, really shutting down the application after each test case might not be the smartest way, and there are other options to do this in a better and more efficient way, but this is something for the later chapters. So we are at the last point of this first section, and this is how to create a report from a run log. And this can be done via file create report. And there are different kinds of report that can be generated. There is an HTML report, the option for an XML report, or for JUnit reports. XML reports can be used for being processed later on in a kind of own way, and JUnit reports can be used for getting imported into test management or test execution tools. And we will create an HTML report, and this is a kind of overview document and shows us the overall test result in a kind of pie chart. And there is an explanation of the symbols here, and this report shows us what test cases and test sets have been executed and what are the errors and also the error details. And when scrolling down, we'll see that here are the test cases. The first one, which was perfectly well, and the second one with the error, and also the error message can be seen in this report, and also screenshots are available here to see the details of the status. So these kind of reports are very helpful as a documentation of your test executions. So we have reached the end of the section one, and in section two we will see how to create our own test suite from scratch and what actions are necessary for this.